Hi, my name is John Cooksey, the host of Cool Video Gear. But before we get started with the video, I have to show you some exciting new products that have just come in. The first ones are Elite Video Long Distance Runner System. It's a sending and decoding box that allows you to send an S-Video YC signal up to 1,250 feet on coax wire or 650 feet on standard small twisted pair two-conductor wire. That's actually what we're doing now. We have an XL1 Canon camera going through the long distance runner, about 300 feet of wire here, two to the decoder and out to our digital video deck. And you can see the quality is still fantastic. This is the first and only of its kind unit to be able to take a thin wire two-conductor and send S-Video long distances. It's fantastic if you're shooting in theater or churches, or if you start up your own video van like we have, you can shoot from long distance away and not have to worry about a quality loss. As you can see, the quality is excellent here. Consider it, look at it in our catalog. It's called the Long Distance Runner. The second item you need to know about is called the Elite Video 3D Surround Processor. It allows you to take mono signals and make them stereo in your duplications, or take stereo signals and get surround sound out of just two speakers. So your customer playing it on two speakers will get a surround sound with just their two speakers. It's a dynamic way to really get that theater sound for your customers. It's an inexpensive item. Look at it in the catalog. It's well worth it. If you have a SD3 duplication amp, or you're making duplications, or you're editing in digital with a digital camera and you really want that higher quality sound than just what's the on camera, this does a lot and has a lot more features. You'll read about in our catalog. The third item is called the Miniplex, and if you're shooting live or you're just short on space in your studio, the Miniplex allows you to take four inputs and display them on the screen at one time. It actually has eight inputs on the back, I'm sorry, so you can have up to eight inputs in and choose any four and put them on the screen. It comes with a little basic titler, so you could put cam 1, cam 2, or whatever on the screen. But it's a great space saver and great for live shoots. It shows them in real time, and it's called the Elite Video Miniplex. All these three brand new items are in our brand new catalog that I'm sure you have now. If you have any questions, give us a call at Elite Video. In the meantime, on with the beginning of Cool Video Gear.
The first product we like to highlight is the SD11 Duplication Station. This allows you to make 10 or 11 duplications at one time if you have that many VCRs. It replaces the SD3 that you saw earlier. This is the newer, improved version, has better resolution boost, and also has the improved circuit called Chroma Processing. The SD11 will allow you to also link multiple SD11s together to make 20, 30, or 40 duplications with something called SuperLink. Now, the nice thing about this unit is it will actually tell you when your duplications are done via, where you see signal controls there, whether it goes to a blank screen or loss of sync. It will tell you with a built-in alarm, but it also has an output so you can hook up an external alarm, so it will actually warn you when your duplications are done. The also nice thing about this is the resolution processor. Now, the resolution processor will give you an improved, sharper image, which will make for better VHS copies. Next to that, you see line loss compensate. What that does is allow you, it doesn't matter what length of lines you use, this unit will allow you to compensate for those by flicking that on. The black burst you see on the left will allow you to black the tapes both before and after if you want, or just use the duplication station for a black burst generating unit. As you can see on the back, it has 10 sets of outputs, stereo, and on the far left there's something called the SuperLink with some switches that allow you to hook together. You see the power, it can run off 12 volts, or it can actually, it comes with an AC adapter, but you can do this with S-Video input or composite inputs. Now, the S-Video input will give you much better quality because the output of decks with the S-Outputs are much better quality, and that resolution translates into your 10 duplications looking better. So if you're looking for the best duplication amp on the market with resolution boost, chroma smear, alarm, black burst, line loss compensate, this is it.
who's really good and I've yet to see come in my office will do the following. They'll shoot the person from a wide shot. They'll also get a shot from beyond the computer, giving some depth of field to the person at the computer. They'll get a shot over the shoulder into the computer screen. And if they're even more creative, they'll rack focus between the computer screen and the reflection of that person. They'll also maybe get an overhead shot. They'll get a very low angle shot, and they'll put the camera on the desk, getting the papers in the foreground. I'm really excited about one of the new products Elite Video has to offer that appeals to all advanced camera people, and it's called Advanced Broadcast Camera Technique. You know, in martial artists, to be the best, you have to be a black belt, and we call this our black belt videographer's tape, because to be the best, you need the best shots. You know, so often videographers think I have to get more and more and more equipment to get them better, but they don't concentrate on their camera work. So what we've done in a videotape is we put 517 of the best clips, 517 of the best kind of shots, and explained why they're good and how they're good and how you can do these into one videotape. It's called Advanced Broadcast Camera Techniques Tape. Out of all the tapes Elite Video has ever edited together, this probably has taken the most amount of time and it's the most highly advanced. We guarantee you a money-back guarantee on this video that you'll improve your video camera work by at least 25% using these techniques. What you're seeing up in the corner here is some clips from the videotape, different shots, and what you're not seeing is the explanations that we have and how to do them and what makes them good and how to make them good. It's a fantastic tape. It's 80 minutes long. We urge everybody to get it. It's $39.95. It's well worth it. It's called Advanced Broadcast Camera Techniques. And in a couple sentences, I've got to tell you, it's the best tape on the market for advanced broadcast camera people. You want to improve your video. You want to get better. There are certain things that you can do to it that don't take a lot of work. They're all covered in this videotape. The name of the videotape is Advanced Broadcast Camera Techniques. It's well worth it, $39.95, 80 minutes, action-packed, jam-packed with 517 examples, plus how to use those and how to make do with them to make your videotape work a lot better. Get the video. It's called Advanced Broadcast Camera Techniques. It's a great video. Next up here, we got a fantastic item called the Universal Video Comparator. It's actually an audio-video duplication checker. And what this allows you to do is check your duplications or compare things. Right here, we have 16 switches. They're actually push buttons, and the number lights up as I push each one. And what this allows you to do is take 16 inputs from VCRs into this, and then take one output out to a monitor. So instead of having 16 monitors to check 16 duplications, you could do it all with this one machine. As a matter of fact, what I do is I simply go through the buttons one at a time like this, let the picture appear for a couple seconds with the audio, and it saves me a lot of time. You know, I used to have to go and check each tape one by one, and sometimes I wouldn't, and a customer would get a tape that was bad. It was really embarrassing for our company. But using this machine, we cut down our bad duplications almost to nothing. And the reason is after we get done with the duplication, we're able to go with this machine, flick the buttons, and check them out. It's 16 channels, but if you want to expand, there's a special thing in the back that allows you to connect more than one, and they'll act like one unit, so you can actually get 32, duplicate 32, and it'll check your stereo audio plus your video. It's called the duplication checker, also called the universal video comparator. If you're a wedding videographer and you've been doing weddings for a couple years, I highly urge you to get the Wedding Videographer's Companion videotape. I know a lot of you have it already, but there's a lot of you that don't. This is over 80 minutes packed with information that will not only improve your wedding editing techniques, but will improve your camera techniques, it will improve your marketing techniques. So many different things are covered on this video. It's just unbelievable. As a matter of fact, we came out with a couple years ago, but what we've been doing is constantly updating it so you get a video that is packed with information about not only doing weddings and the advanced techniques, but again about the marketing and saving editing time and different things that you can do to make yourself not only one of the best wedding videographers out in your area, but the most highly paid and the most in demand. We take you through all different examples. We show you what to do and how to do it to make more money and to make sure you're one of the greatest wedding videographers in your area. It's definitely the best tape out there on weddings. We think that if you're serious about it and you just learn a few things from this tape that you didn't know before that can boost your productivity and boost your income, then it's well worth it. Get the video. It's called The Wedding Videographer's Companion. It's $35 and worth every penny. If you're in the edit room and you need ultimate audio control, we suggest the 1402 by Mackie. This is one of the best mixers on the market. It's very versatile. It'll allow you to take sources from different input VCRs. You can take them also from a tape deck and a CD deck and microphones. You can even record a band with this as a videographer. It has six of the XLR inputs. Of course, you could also use quarter inch or with adapters RCA, and it's got more quarter inch inputs, total of 10 inputs with the sliders. You can combine four of these to have up to 14 channels inputted into this and adjusted. There's effects mixes, and there's three band equalization, bass, treble, and mid-range for each channel. There's an LED meter over here, which gives you control over what you're seeing. There's solo buttons. There's beautiful faders. This is a well-built piece of machinery, and whether you're a videographer that's just doing your average or event work, or whether you're doing depositions for legal work, or you're videotaping bands and you need lots of microphones put in, for under $500, the Mackie 1402 mixer is the ideal mixer for anybody's edit room. One piece of video equipment we think every videographer should have in their edit suite is the BVP4 Plus Broadcast Video Processor. You see it here. You're seeing samples of the BVP4 Plus on the screen now, the before and after as the split screen pans over. It's a fabulous machine because it can not only improve Super VHS, VHS, High 8, but it could also improve digital video. And everybody thinks digital video is so good to begin with. How can it get better? But it can. You'll see it on our demo tape. And if you're still skeptical, we have a plan for people to send in their mini digital videotapes, and we can actually improve the footage that they send in, or samples they send in, and put it back on the same tape. As a matter of fact, you can contact us on our main office if you'd like to see the BVP4 Plus demonstrated on your own footage, because we find that if you see your own footage demonstrated and improved, you will be a true convert over to the BVP4 Plus. It's much different than most video proc amps in that it has unique controls like the PTP luminance, the super saturation color level, the black restore, and the resolution boost. And when you combine these processes together, you get dramatic results as you see on the screen here. Now, we also urge you to get the 30-minute demo tape, which shows many more samples than we could possibly show you here and explains how all the different processes on the BVP4 Plus work. The other thing I'd like to do is I'd like to get Annie sitting up here in the place that I'm at so we can do a before and after, and you can see the improvement that the BVP4 Plus makes. Here's Annie right now with no BVP4 in line, And as a matter of fact, we're going to hit a bypass switch. We have a super switch hooked up, and we do the bypass. And now the BVP4 is in line, out of line, in line, so you can see there's no degradation to the signal. And then we use the split screen to turn it over, and you can adjust the color level, and you can see a real big difference. And some people find this too hard to believe, so what we suggest to do is we'll just turn it on all the way and use the bypass switch. This is before, this is after, this is before, this is after, and you can see the detail. Annie, give us a nice smile there so we can see the sparkle. And you can play around with the signal to make it really rich. You can adjust the flesh tones. Of course, you don't want to overdo it. And do things to make your signal a lot better. Of course, this is a really good signal to begin with. You know, if we have a signal that's not as good, it can make even more dramatic improvement. And this signal is coming right from digital. So you could see that it really makes a big difference. And by using the bypass switch, you could see that our unit doesn't affect, but in fact does improve the signal and doesn't degrade it in any way. It's a great machine. It's well worth under the $1,000 that you can get it for. And whether you're working with digital or you're working with Super VHS or Hi8, this unit really does a job of improving your video signal and making it a lot better. I want you to give our office a call about the BVP4 Plus so we can get you out one of our demo tapes, or you can send in some of your footage and we can make arrangements to improve that and send it back to you so you could see how well this processor does and not only improving footage that's not that great to begin with, but also improving footage that's already great to begin with. Your final product will look a lot better using the BVP4 Plus processor. It's not like any other proc amp out there because it has so many different features not found anywhere else to give you a brighter, sharper picture with more resolution. Give us a call today about it. We'll get you set up.
Hi, my name's Annie, and I'm here to tell you about this great copy stand that'll work well with any sort of video setup that you happen to have. Now, it includes everything that you see here, except, of course, the camera, and the light bulbs. And you can use any sort of light bulb, either regular or quartz, from any hardware or discount store. Now, this is wonderful for transferring photographs or still images. Now, let's go with a live shot here. I'm going to get some pictures of some kitties down here. Look like my kitties. We're going to go in and see how beautiful that is. Beautifully framed up. Now, you can record this image or transfer from any camcorder into another VCR, which is what we're doing right here. Now, it's a very reasonable price. It's under $200, and it fits any size camcorder. It can be, we've got a medium one here, but you can go smaller, a little bit larger. And you know, whether you're working part-time or full-time in the video business, this will be great for any video setup that you happen to have. It's well worth it.
Introducing the new Elite Video TFT5500. This is the 5.6-inch LCD monitor. It mounts on a camera with a special mounting bracket, or it just stands by itself. The nice thing about it is it weighs less than a pound, and you can carry it on the job with you. We also have an optional swivel mount not shown here for the top of the camera. That's an additional $25, but I'll tell you, this monitor works fantastic because it runs off 12 volts and you can get an optional little battery pack to run it off 10 AA's, or it can run off an adapter that comes with it. It'll stand on its own or mount on its camera. As you can see, the picture quality is amazing. It's got all your adjustment controls on the side. It's compact, and even viewing it at an angle, you get a fantastic looking picture. So if you need something light and portable for the job, it's the TFT 5500 5.6 inch LCD monitor.
One way to really jazz up your productions is with the Rabbite series of animations. These are professional broadcast animations, and you can use them on any of your productions. There's over 18 volumes, and they are royalty free. They come on Super VHS, which means if you, no matter what format you use, once you put them over to your format of your choice, in our case digital, they look fantastic. And we can have a videotape available, which is a demo tape, that shows you every animation in its entirety in a quarter screen. You're seeing it here. These are some shots from volume 1 through 4. And what we urge you to do is get this demonstration tape. It's $20. It allows you to see all the animations all the way through in their entirety. So it takes about 2 hours to go through. You're just seeing little clips of it here. But it allows you to see which volumes would be great for you. Each volume has about 35 animations on them, and they're from all different occasions. You know, when you have a couple of these animations, whether it's corporate, industrial, or wedding, you'll find a use for them. You own the rights to these animations, which means that once you get this tape, you get the full version of these animations. A lot of them have black, as you can see, like volume 7 right there. Volume 9, 10, 11, 12 all have different things too. As you can see on volume 12, there's some areas where you can key in something in the background too. The key is to get the full demo and be able to look through and see which ones you want. You know, we use a lot of these for our productions where we'll take a nice generic background of a globe or of a VCR video and superimpose titles over it and it looks professional. On this videotape and on all our videotapes, we have some of these on there somewhere, and they're just so great to use because they're a great way to impress clients. Even if you haven't done the production for the client, you can take a nice background like the cityscape or whatever and superimpose the client's titles of what their video is going to be, and it's just really impressive because the client thinks you did all this work and you really haven't done that much. If you were to do your own animations with some computer or something, they probably wouldn't turn out as good, and you might take 20, 30 hours to do it. The nice things about these animations is you're able to take a nice stock background, superimpose your title or key in whatever you need, and it gives the same impression without doing all the work. Once again, you own the rights to these animations. You get over 35 on a tape. Let's just suppose you got an animations tape and they're $69, and out of that $69 tape, you only used one. Well, you would have to spend 20 hours, probably 15 hours, doing something similar, and it might not even come out as good. Whereas this way, you're able to get the animations down, get them down fast, have a big selection, and not have to spend tons of time on it. So remember, that's the Rabbite animations. There's at least 35 on a tape. And out of that 35 on tape, if you use one or two, it would be well worth it. Comes in SVHS format, which will transfer great to any particular format. Let's put those back up on the screen again just to show you once more. We have volumes 13, 14, 15, 16 demonstrated here, but you can get up to, we have 18 or 19 volumes now. Get the demo tape. It's $20. That's refundable. Once you get one of the units here, one or two of them, you can get the money back on the demo tape. It's well worth it because you're going to get almost 2 hours of getting to see all these animations in action, and the demo tape is just well worth the money, and the animations can really jazz up your productions. One problem that's often a frustration for videographers is being able to afford the rights to music to put on their video productions. Well, we at Elite Video created a compact disc, a CD, digital recorded of all different kinds of songs that sound like something that you might have heard before. And what's great about this is you don't have to pay any royalties. Now, normally royalty-free music CDs, you might get 10 or 11 or 12 different songs of various length on one CD and have to pay $69, $79, $89 minimum for a CD. Here we have a CD that's $49, and you can hear the quality of the music's excellent, and we don't have 10 or 12, but we have 27 different songs on the tape. As a matter of fact, let's get a close-up of the CD right here. And it's hard to see, but there are 27 different songs on the tape, as well as things like fanfares and sound effects. It's a great CD to get. Actually, it's only available on CD. We don't put it on tape because the quality is so good, digitally recorded right to digital. And you can hear we have a little bit of something for everything. Now, what we say to people is, even if there's one or two songs that you find on here that you like that you use in a production, we're paying $49.95 for those songs versus $3,000 to $6,000 for the rights to songs that are the actual songs would be very expensive. Here are sort of sound-alike songs. You might hear something in the tape that sounds sort of like the Beatles or like surfboard music, or something that might sound like an old blues tune or country. We've tried to include a little on here. As a matter of fact, reading it off, we have a heavy metal tune, country tune, a James Taylor sounding kind of tune, of course a hard rock kind of tune. We have a one that sounds like old time kind of slow rock and roll, and one that sounds like 1950s and 60s fast rock and roll. A little bit of everything from jazz to country to rock and roll. It's well worth getting, because for under $50 you get 27 songs plus fanfares and sound effects. It's more than you've ever seen put together in one CD. As a matter of fact, let's listen to a couple clips right now. Here's a song with a nice country rock flavor called Easy Eyes. For those of you into techno disco, here's a nice song called Rave Review. And here's a song with a nice 1970s disco flavor called Queen Dancer. Whether it's a 50s slow kind of tune, or it's some kind of faster tune, you get the variety in the CD, and that's why we call it Variety Pack. As a matter of fact, right now we're gonna leave you with samples from all the different songs on the CD, and then we're gonna put our phone number up on the screen so you can see the phone number to call to get this. It's under $50, it gives you 27 songs, digitally recorded plus sound effects, a lot of them done with a live band. If you use one or two of them for a couple productions, it'll be well worth it. We think
program to bring you the Monitor Mate, which is a Bogan piece. Actually, it's three pieces that clip on your tripod that allow you to put a mixer, a monitor, any kind of thing that you want on your tripod. It simply clamps on, and then it has this ball joint that snaps in really well. And the nice thing about this is you can adjust your monitor tray any way you want. It can hold up to 15 pounds at all various different angles. So you can have it up the tripod or down the tripod. It installs as fast as you're seeing it install here. You take the top piece and it clamps right in. And as you'll notice, the shelf has a lip around it to prevent things from slipping off, as well as what we call safety belts that allow your monitor to go right on. It'll hold up to 15 pounds, whether you want a monitor or you want to hold mixer or wireless microphones or anything. The Monitor Mate is a great deal at $117. It'll work on any tripod and well worth it.
I want to mention two other products that are important if you own a Sony digital camcorder. The first is the 5-hour battery that we offer. It has a special plug-in for the digital video power connector, and then it comes with a charger, plugs in here, it'll run your camcorder for 5 hours, up to 5 hours, by simply clipping on your belt pack. In the back here, it has a special connection that flips right on your belt pack, and it'll hang on there, and the cord goes right to your digital camcorder, something you may want to consider for running your camcorder a long period of time. The other thing is the Cinema Products Company is coming out with a Steadicam specifically for digital. We have a shot of it here, and it's due out in November of 1997. So if you have the digital camcorder, you may want to consider getting one of these. They're going to be selling for under $1,000. It's a nice way to get those smooth shots that the professionals give in the movies. If you're one of those people that has the digital camera, we have a fantastic item that fits right on the bottom that allows you to put in XLR inputs, either mic or line. Let's take a look at that right now. It's the Beats Dual XLR adapter, and it has two volume controls here. It also allows you to plug in XLR inputs, and you can switch between mic and line with those XLR inputs. Right now, to demonstrate the quality of this, I'm going to have Nick, our engineer, shut down my lav mic, and we're going to turn on this mic here. This is a microphone that we offer for about $99 in our catalog. It's a great mic, a great sounding vocal mic if you ever have to do voiceovers, and we've plugged it right in to the camcorder via the XLR adapter. So what you're doing is hearing me right now just as how it would come out on your digital camcorder. Now the nice thing is you can adjust the volume. I'm going to do that here. Turn it down. And I'm turning it up as I'm talking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So it has really high quality volume controls for each channel. It's a high quality chassis. It's very, very low noise, as you could hear right here. What you're hearing is right off the camera. The line outputs, we're taking it right into our digital deck right now. So it's a fantastic device and allows you to mix. You can even mix between a microphone like this and a line input, say from a soundboard. So if you're doing a band or something like that, it would allow you to mix between live mics and mics right off the soundboard or a dance recital or anything else. It's fantastic quality, allows two inputs with the mic and line switch. Now, if you want to see what each separate channel is doing, then we suggest getting a brand new product we have, calling the VU meter for the digital camcorders. And let's take a look at that. Here's a close-up of our dual UV meter for audio. Right now you're seeing just the right channel light up. It has two channels, both the left and the right, but I only have one microphone in now. If I wanted to show both channels lighting up, I would either have to have two inputs, or in the case of this digital camera, I would use the on-camera mic. I'll show you right now as I disconnect the dual XLR adapter with this handheld mic. Right now you're hearing my voice on the on-camera microphone, which is stereo, so you're hearing both left and right channels at the same time. You can see the meter goes up, and if it's too loud, if it was really loud, it goes up to the red and distorts. And this allows you to take your digital camera and adjust the record level in the back to get the perfect audio for both left and right channels. Say, for example, if you have one wireless and one wired microphone, or you're doing a music video where you have one microphone that is in the audience and the other line connected directly to the digital camera. It's a great thing to have even if you don't have the dual XLR adapter, because it allows you to see exactly what's going on from the top of your camera. It mounts right on the hot shoe. It gets its power from the power source directly in the camera. It plugs right into the side here, and it's a fantastic unit for under $200. It eliminates guesswork, and that's the important thing. So if you're looking for two excellent products for your digital camcorder, you want to think about this dual UV meter and the dual XLR adapter. As a matter of fact, there are some things that claim to do similar things to the dual XLR adapter, but they don't come close. I'd like to demonstrate that one more time by taking the volume control and counting down from 10 backwards and turning it down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You can see the quality is excellent, even down all the way. You don't get any background noise. It's a well-built unit. As a matter of fact, it's used by some major networks in their TV shows where they take one of these digital cameras out for nice little remote shots. You have the XLR adapter, very high quality. You never know when you're going to need it, so you want to make sure you have it. And you have the dual view it meter, which is the VU meter that allows you to make sure your audio is right on check with your digital camera. Now, this can only be used with the Sony digital camera. The XLR adapter can be used with the Sony digital camera or the Panasonic digital camera. As a matter of fact, it can also be used with any small camcorder. You just have to specify what camcorder you have, because two models are slightly different. They're excellent products, and if you're doing video work, this is something that you should have. I know a lot of videographers out there are doing corporate work or special events, and they're looking for something different. They're looking for some kind of thing where they can be in control of their own time. And that's true with something called Subsidy Video. We produce a package at Elite that's $99 that includes 3 videotapes, plus software, plus contracts, plus everything you need to know to get into Subsidy Video. You're seeing clips from the videotapes now up here in the corner. And Subsidy Video is a great way, if you live in a town of over 20,000 or more, to do instructional how-to videos that take one day to shoot, a half day to edit. There's people in your town, whether they be lawyers or robotics instructors, cooking instructors, that need a video done. They need one-stop shopping. They need a reasonable rate. And also, they need it so we can get it done fast. With Subsidy Video, you take care of them step by step all the way through. It basically makes $150 to $200 per hour for you because you're only videotaping one day and editing a half day, so you end up netting $2,400, $2,500. It's up to you. If you live in a town of 20,000 or more, you have a couple cameras and a mixers, Subsidy Video is not only a profitable way, but a very fun way and a nice change from doing special events or corporate work, because you can videotape when you want, where you want, and you control the shoot. You're the director. It's like you're the record company finding that special music group out there, except you are a video producer finding the person that already has a following that needs a video done. We guarantee you money back guarantee plus $35 that you'll get at least a few jobs using the Subsidy Video kit. Includes the videotapes, the contracts, complete booklet of everything here, software. It's well worth it. It's called the Subsidy Video Kit. And I urge you to read more about it in our catalog. Once again, it includes everything here plus technical support. We guarantee you success as long as you have a video mixer, a couple camcorders, and if you're looking for a change of pace, this is it, the Subsidy Video Kit. Here's a shot of lovely Annie on the screen, and believe it or not, she's split screen between two images, but you can't see that because there's such a slight difference. The two images are between the normal 6-foot video cable and the 75-foot hyper cable. A lot of people think, wow, if you go 75 feet, even if it's a great cable like the hyper cable, there's going to be loss. But we're here to tell you that the hyper cable loss is so minimal you can't tell the difference. And to prove it, let's put on a split screen image here. And you can see that there is a difference, but it's so slight. On the right is the 75-foot image, and on the left is the 6-foot normal cable. And you can see the loss is so minor that it's almost not even worth worrying about. On the right is the 75-foot, and on the left is the 6-foot. And the hyper cable can go 75-foot without a noticeable loss. Now, if you look really carefully, like this, here you can't really tell, but if I put up the split screen and you look really carefully, you can see that there's a slight change, a little bit more chroma to the picture going 75 feet. Nick is going to pull out a little bit so we can see a little bit more green on an average kind of picture. The hyper cable doesn't give you a loss that you really have to worry about at 75 feet. Now, hyper cable comes in 20 foot, which is even less of a change than what you're seeing here. And hyper cable also comes in the 75 foot, and you can combine 75 foots together. But here we have one 75 foot, and if I don't put this line in the middle of the screen, odds are you can't even tell where the 6 foot begins and where the 75 foot is. We took the lead out of the camera and split it in a distribution amplifier and send one to one side of the AV7 mixer and the other to the other side, and you can see the hyper cables, even at 75 feet, give you a loss which is so little that it's not even worth worrying about if you're going 75 feet.
you can see here, we just have Amanda in our studio. The only light that we have is the backlight. We turned all overhead and all studio lights out to give you the real meaning of the PhotoFlex system. On to the main light. In our studio, we have this situated a little bit to the right of Amanda, because we're also going to go through the main light and also a fill light, which will be on your left-hand side. You can see here we've got a little bit of shadows on the left-hand side, but nothing real harsh. Her skin tone and her colors on her shirt, and also the colors of the background, still stand out and are the original colors. Okay, now as you can tell, we turned on our fill light, which is on the left-hand side. Again, if you notice this neckline and also the shapes of the face, the shadows have disappeared. As you'll notice, even with just the fill light on the left-hand side, the quality is still excellent. You can still see the flesh tone is very clear, not too dark, not too bright. And also all the colors, the background colors, the blues and the greens are coming out very clear. Now I'd like to go on to showing you an on-camera light. In this case, we're using the NRG VariaLight. As you can see, it's very harsh. The eyes are very, you can't even really tell the color of her eyes because they are glaring. The light is very bright. As you can see here, we took away the backlight just to show you as if you're in the field and there was a wall, or if there was nothing behind her, of course, you wouldn't have the shadow. But still, if you notice the hot spots on her face, which is the shining and the glimmering of her face, it's very bright. We're trying to move it around a little bit just to give you an idea of the different situations. Okay, now I've gone back to the PhotoFlex system just to give you a quick idea, closing, of what the PhotoFlex is compared to your NRG. This again is the PhotoFlex system, which you got from Elite Video. Okay, now this is your NRG. Again, you can see that there's a lot of hot spots on the face. Here is the PhotoFlex. This time I'm showing you the PhotoFlex with just the main light turned on. Obvious when you actually look at the two next to each other or back to back in sequence, you can actually really tell the difference between a PhotoFlex soft light system and the NRG light or any on-camera light you might have.
Hi, this is Annie, and I'm here to let you know a little bit more about Elite Video's instructional videotapes. You've already heard about the Wedding Videographer's Companion. While we also offer one on the MX-1, we offer one on the Title Maker and the AB-1 Edit Suite, and a whole bunch more that you don't see here. Now, the neat thing about training tapes is it lets you see exactly how to use the piece of equipment, which is a little bit easier than flipping through a manual. And our videotapes all offer a little bit more than what's in the manual, a couple extra tips and tricks that you're able to use. So why don't you flip through your catalog or get onto the web at www.elitevideo.com, and why don't you see which ones that you can pick out for your video studio.
A lot of people out there are doing things with chroma key. Chroma key is something you do if you have an MX-1 mixer, an AV-55 mixer, MX-30, MX-50. The mixers have a chroma key feature which allows you to key in the background on a solid color. Now here on this actual set, we used a chroma key background just for the pretty green color in the background. I'm going to show you what our set is like now and what the chroma key background looks like. Right here, you can see that it's a black edged 5.5 feet by 7.5 feet piece of fabric that you can chroma key over, in this case use for a set. What I'm going to do now is show you how we could use it for chroma key by removing the plants. We had this plant here to add a shadow, and we had this plant here for looks. And once I remove these out of the background, there will no longer be shadows on the chroma key background. The other thing about this chroma key background is we also have stands and clamps that can go with it, so you could quickly adjust it to any size and set it up really easy in any situation. Right here we have a light that's adding a highlight to the back of the chroma key. You don't necessarily want that when you're doing chroma key because it may add too bright of an image. So we're going to turn that off. So we have a nice even image, though we do have a shadow. And generally speaking, you want to light your background and foreground separately. The nice thing about this background is it's portable. You can hang it up, you can purchase it without the stands and clamps, or with the stands and clamps. But it's a simple piece of that actually goes in a container. And to fold it up at the end of the job, you simply take the corners, squish them together, and of course I do it easy. I've had this for a while. And it goes right in a carrying case, simply slips away. And then when you get to the job and you want to unfold it, you do the same thing, and it quickly unfolds. You could bring it so it's the tall way, or you could bring it this way. And even one person can set it up by taking it with the clamps and clamping it on light stands we provide, or if you add light stands yourself. So it's a simple setup and takedown. The important thing, again, once you're doing chroma key, is to light your foreground. We're using it here with soft light system, and also to light your background separately. So you can have a lot of fun with the chroma key background. You can get it with or without the stands. It folds up easy, and you have a lot of fun. Thanks for joining us today on Cool Video Stuff, and we hope to see you again in the future. A reminder, if you decide you want to copy this videotape, you can, and we will not be upset. That's right, unlike our other tapes, you can actually copy this one for your friends. Make as many copies as you want. The only catch is you have to make sure that you keep it in its entirety, do not add or subtract anything, and we ask you that if you do make a copy, write on the label that it's a copy from a VHS dub. We look forward to seeing you sometime in the future, and if you'd like to contact us, you can call us at our office, or you can get at our website at www.elitevideo.com and either email us or look around at the most asked questions section. There's a lot going on there too. We've had a lot of fun. Look forward to seeing you in the future. Thanks for joining us today. Thanks for joining us for our bonus sections. Up first, we have a demonstration of the motion picture maker. The motion picture maker is a device, an electronic device, that's basically a moving table that sits on the bottom part of your copy stand, mounting your camera above, and allows you to move an object left, right, up and down in any direction. This is fantastic for scrolling invitations or for putting any pictures on and making them look like they move. Now, the great thing about this device is you don't have to just go left, right, back and forth. Combination of the pan and scrolls from the wired remote control will enable you to simulate movement. You can slow down to very slow or speed up. Here's a shot right here from a small snapshot that's about 3.5 inches by 5.5 inches. But by using the motion picture maker on the tray, you're able to go in any direction. Stephanie's demonstrating here from the wide shot. It's such a small picture, but you can even, with a small picture, give the illusion of motion. And once you get used to the controls, the speed controls, and the up and down and back and forth controls, you can do a lot with this machine. And it's really handy if you're a wedding videographer or a documentarian and want to take those still shots and add motion to them. We're demonstrating it here on some postage stamps and some postmarks just to show you how small the item can be that you can actually pan and scroll, and how fast and how slow you can speed it up or slow it down. You know, if you saw the old Civil War series on PBS a few years ago, they used items like this to pan and scroll. It's really handy. It's called the Motion Picture Maker. It mounts on a copy stand with your camera. It's available now for under $900. If you want more information, give us a call at the Elite Video. For those of you with the digital camcorders, we now offer a hard shell case for under $75. This is a hard shell case for the digital camcorder. Its foam is custom cut out to fit the digital camcorder perfectly,
and it'll fit a battery, a couple tapes, and the charger. You can even cut out an extra piece of foam if you want to fit another battery. It's all in there snug. It's aluminum, which means it'll keep away the rain and the elements. It looks like a regular briefcase. It's inobtrusive. You have your locks on it. Very sturdy, heavy-duty things. You can stand on it. It's a great buy. If you're looking for a way to stand out from other videographers in the pack, consider colored VHS tapes. We have them in all different colors. You can buy them in packs of 50. It's well worth it. For this next section, we'd like to give you a demonstration of the difference between an on-camera mic and a new shotgun we sell called a Sennheiser.
With the on-camera mic on a Sony DV1000, VX1000, let's plug in the shotgun. Now here's with the shotgun mic, so you can hear the difference of how much better it can make it, and a little clearer, even with some background noise, it actually puts out a really pretty good sound. As you can see, I'm probably 10, 12 feet away. Let's go back to the other mic. Right now, we're using the on-camera mic. It doesn't quite have the touch and quality or the directional ability. And to give you another comparison, let's go back to the shotgun, the Sennheiser shotgun. This is the shotgun mic, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a Sennheiser shotgun. It's an excellent microphone if you're doing anything where you need to pick up people in a directional kind of area. And let's try it inside now. This is the on-camera mic. We're inside and it's picking up my voice pretty good, but we're gonna switch over to the shotgun Sennheiser. Now we have the shotgun plugged in and you can hear the difference. And we're gonna test one more time again. First, we're gonna go back to the on-camera microphone. Check 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the on-camera microphone, giving you an idea how it sounds. And we're gonna do the shotgun microphone. This is shotgun microphone, 1, 2, 3, 4. I hope this tape gives you a little bit of idea of the difference between on-camera microphone and the power of a Sennheiser shotgun.
Normally the Sennheiser shotgun is $249, but if you call our office and mention this tape, you can save $30. What I have in my hand here actually looks like a purse. It's got a nice leather case, but you'd be surprised to find out that it's a portable audio mixer. It does run on one rechargeable battery in the back that'll last over about 17 hours. We call it the Portamix system. Has three XLR inputs as well as trim controls, so you can get a lot of gain, separate bass and treble and effects channels for each channel, and a pan knob because this is a stereo mixer if you want to do stereo. It has six inputs, three of which are stereo, or you can go nine if you're going with the mono. It's got the main output here. It's got peak level indicators, power. The quality is great. It's got the quarter inch outputs here, but you can also go to XLR with a special cable so you can have XLR in and out that Elite Video sells. It's the Portamix 9 series. It snaps together like a purse, has a handle. It's a great mixer for any of your video needs. Remember, the Portamix 9 also includes rechargeable battery and charger.
First, there was mono. Then there was stereo. And now there's the new 3D sound.
something. I wanna hold your hand.
Now you've had a chance to hear it. Even on a dry, lifeless mono recording, the 3D Sound Sculptor hears the spatial information and at the flick of a button gives you fully dimensional, sparkling stereo like nothing else you've ever experienced. With your S5 3D Surround processor, you'll enjoy real enhancement for all your video projects.
Up or slow it down. You know, if you saw the old Civil War series on PBS a few years ago, they used items like this to pan and scroll. It's really handy. It's called the Motion Picture Maker. Mounts on a copy stand with your camera. It's available now for under $900. If you want more information, give us a call at the Elite Video. For those of you with the digital camcorders, we now offer a hard shell case for under $75. This is a hard shell case for the digital camcorder. Its foam is custom cut out to fit the digital camcorder perfectly, and it'll fit a battery, a couple tapes, and the charger. You can even cut out an extra piece of foam if you want to fit another battery. It's all in there snug. It's aluminum, which means it'll keep away the rain and the elements. It looks like a regular briefcase. It's inobtrusive. You have your locks on it. Very sturdy, heavy-duty things. You can stand on it. It's a great buy. If you're looking for a way to stand out from other videographers in the pack, consider colored VHS tapes. We have them in all different colors. You can buy them in packs of 50. It's well worth it. For this next section, we'd like to give you a demonstration of the difference between an on-camera mic and a new shotgun we sell called a Sennheiser.
Start with the on-camera mic on a Sony DV1000, VX1000, and let's plug in the shotgun. Now here's with the shotgun mic, so you can hear the difference of how much better it can make it, and a little clearer, even with some background noise, it actually puts out a really pretty good sound. As you can see, I'm probably 10, 12 feet away. Let's go back to the other mic. Right now we're using the on-camera mic. It doesn't quite have the punch and quality or the directional ability. And to give you another comparison, let's go back to the shotgun, the Sennheiser shotgun. This is the shotgun mic, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a Sennheiser shotgun. It's an excellent microphone if you're doing anything where you need to pick up people in a directional kind of area. And let's try it inside now. This is the on-camera mic. We're inside and it's picking up my voice pretty good, but we're going to switch over to the shotgun Sennheiser. Now we have the shotgun plugged in and you can hear the difference, and we're going to test one more time again. First, we're going to go back to the on-camera microphone. Check 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the on-camera microphone, giving you an idea how it sounds, and we're going to do the shotgun microphone. This is the shotgun microphone, 1, 2, 3, 4. I hope this tape gives you a little bit of idea of the difference between on-camera microphone and the power of a Sennheiser shotgun.
Normally the Sennheiser shotgun is $249, but if you call our office and mention this tape, you can save $30. What I have in my hand here actually looks like a purse. It's got a nice leather case, but you'd be surprised to find out that it's a portable audio mixer. It does run on one rechargeable battery in the back that'll last over about 17 hours. We call it the Portamix system. Has three XLR inputs as well as trim controls, so you can get a lot of gain, separate bass and treble and effects channels for each channel, and a pan knob because this is a stereo mixer if you want to do stereo. It has six inputs, three of which are stereo, or you can go 9 if you're going with the mono. It's got the main output here. It's got peak level indicators, power. The quality is great. It's got the quarter inch outputs here, but you can also go to XLR with a special cable, so you can have XLR in and out that Elite Video sells. It's the Portamix 9 series. It snaps together like a purse, has a handle. It's a great mixer for any of your video needs. Remember, the Portamix 9 also includes rechargeable battery and charger.
First, there was mono. Then there was stereo. And now there's the new
3D Sound.
Now you've had a chance to hear it. Even on a dry, lifeless mono recording, the 3D Sound Sculptor hears the spatial information and at the flick of a button gives you fully dimensional sparkling stereo like nothing else you've ever experienced. With your S5 3D Surround processor, you'll enjoy real enhancement for all your video projects.